Hopes of finding more survivors in the massive landslide in Davao de Oro now fading. The death toll in the tragedy has climbed to 55. Over 60 others remain missing or unaccounted for. A Davao de Oro provincial information officer said emergency responders have shifted to search and retrieval operations nearly a week since the tragedy struck.
If there's help from other agency, and there will be more heavy equipments needed in order to fast track the clearing of this 50 meters, 30 meters thick of land that fell on the ground, and with that 1.9 kilometers range of the cover that being spell of the land during the landslide. That's still the hope. No? It's still the hope of the governor, Justice Dorothy Gonzaga. It's the hope of Congressman Attorney Roel Peter Gonzaga, who happens to be the incident command post commander. It's still the hope of the ground commander in the ground zero, Colonel Jerry Bisanya. All of us still hoping that there's still people alive. But talking with the reality, more than 6 days, buried over this 50 meters thick of land and 13 meters thick of land. So most probably these people already died.
Let's open the week in corporate stories. Figaro Coffee Group reports a 7% increase in net income by the end of 2023. This amounted to nearly 283 million pesos from the 265 million year on year. The food business group points to higher volume sales from its store opening and expansion efforts. System-wide sales in the second half of last year also up by 36% to 2.8 billion pesos. Figaro opened 38 new stores in the latter part of 2023, bringing its total stores to 203. Meanwhile, Apex Mining cuts back on milling activities after the deadly landslide near its operating site in Davao de Oro province. The company also expects lower output and sales of gold and silver in its next shipment due to the limited operations. Apex says measures will be taken to address production gaps once authorities complete the search and rescue, as well as clearing operations. It previously vowed support for the efforts and for the affected residents. Finally, NLEX Corporation strengthens its road safety campaign. The Metro Pacific Tollways unit unveiled this month its road traffic safety hub and park in Mabalacat Town in Pampanga. NLEX says the facility will be used for safety training seminars and to help ensure responsible driving. Foreign direct investments into the Philippines climbed to $1 billion in November. This was higher by 27.8% from the $820 million in 2022. The Banco Central says foreign investments in debt instruments made up most of the net inflows at $897 million. But net investments in equity capital and in reinvestment in earnings both contracted to $85 million and $66 million, respectively. Now, equity capital placements were largely from Japan and the U.S. and were channeled mostly to manufacturing, real estate, and construction. Year-to-date, though, the FDI net inflows were lower by over 13%. The cumulative figure was at $7.6 billion from $8.7 billion year-on-year. The BSP says FDI remains subdued from lingering effects of high inflation and lower global growth prospects and demand. Elon Musk has been ordered by a judge to comply with a subpoena to answer questions from regulators about his takeover of Twitter, now called X. The court granted the Securities and Exchange Commission's application to enforce the subpoena. Musk and the SEC now have a week to agree on a time and place for a deposition. This comes after Musk snubbed a scheduled deposition in September. The investigation centers on Musk's purchases of Twitter shares in 2022 before he bought the company for $44 billion. The International Monetary Fund sees the growth of Middle East economy slowing this year due to oil production cuts and the war in Gaza. This even as the global economic outlook remained resilient. Now, in a recent regional economic report, the IMF revised its GDP growth forecast for the Middle East and North America down to 2.9% this year. The IMF says tourism revenues of countries neighboring Israel and Palestine are being affected by the conflict, while the Red Sea attacks by Houthi rebels weighed on freight costs. Just last month, the IMF raised its forecast for global economic growth, upgrading the outlook for both the United States and China, citing faster-than-expected easing of inflation. Asia-Pacific markets struggle for direction even after Wall Street ended Friday's trade in the green. Top of mind for investors today, U.S. January inflation data, which will be out on Tuesday. It is expected to come in at 2.9%. Now, if that materializes, it would be the first reading below 3% since March 2021. Taking a look at the board now, most major indices in Asia are closed Monday, including those in Hong Kong, Taiwan, and South Korea. The ASX 200 closed in the red following a three-day winning streak during last week's trading. Let's take a look at futures in Europe now. They are set for a mixed open following a holiday thin trade in Asia. Contracts tied to the German DAX are flat, while the French CAC 40 looks poised for a positive open. Stateside now, Wall Street futures are little changed after a record week for the S&P 500, which closed above 5,000 for the first time on Friday. Investors this week will be watching out for key data on consumer and producer prices. The Philippine military takes down the alleged mastermind in last year's deadly bombing of the Mindanao State University. The armed forces says it killed Gaddafi Mimbesa, also known as Engineer, in an operation in Lanao del Sur late last month. Nine other members of the Daulah Islamiyah were also neutralized. The military now calling on remnants of the terror group to surrender.
This is a very, very significant blow on their end because he is one of the leaders. And so we foresee that the group will actually be in a state of low morale as of this time. And thus, we are really doing our best to continue on our pursuit operations.
The MSU bombing occurred during Sunday Mass last December, killing four and wounding dozens of others.